you know that you need to be very careful with the logarithm. A power function is defined in terms of a logarithm, so you need to be careful with power functions too. In this video, we will see how we can make power functions analytic. We will also find the inverse image of a point, which is far from trivial, as you will see in this video. So, how are our power functions defined? Well, you have f from c without 0 to c, f of z equals z to the power c, and take c not in z. So not functions like z squared, but c in z, c in complex number, but not in z. In that case, we have f of z equals e to the power c log z becomes multivalued. F of z becomes multivalued if your c is not in z. So we can cure that by taking the principal value, and then we have our f of z as e to the power c log of z, where we have the capital log now. Okay, function is not multivalued anymore, but single value, we took the principal values. But now we have another problem, because if you go around the origin with your log in the domain, you jump in the codomain, which means that your log is not continuous, and so your e to the power c log that also will be not continuous. Well, we can fix that property, of course, by taking a branch cut, so by taking f from a domain of f to c, where we restrict the arguments between minus pi and pi, but taking out the sets where the argument equals pi. And of course, we take sets equals 0 out too, still. And in that case, your f of z equals z to the power c equals e to the power z c log z, it's a capital L, now is analytic, because the log of z is analytic now, composition of analytic functions is analytic, and the exponential function is analytic too. So, now we have an analytic function. So we can differentiate. What do we get if we differentiate e to the power c is log z? Well, then we get e to the power c log z times the derivative of c log z, which equals c over z. Well, e to the power c log z equals z to the power c. So we get z to the power c times c over z. So we get c to times z to the power c minus 1, which is just a familiar rule for differentiation of power functions. Now let's try to find the inverse image of a point. So find all z such that the principal value of z to the power 1 plus I is some given complex number. Well, the number on the right-hand side looks horrible, but it will become nice in a moment, so don't worry. How are we going to solve this problem? Well, you have to be careful. You cannot just take logs left and right, because the log of e to the power z is not equal to z in all cases, so you have to be more careful here. So, what can we do? Well, we will do three steps. First of all, rewrite right-hand side, then rewrite left-hand side, and then step C, equate them again. So rewrite right-hand side. First, write the right-hand side in polar form. Well, we can rewrite it as e to the power 2 pi over square root of 2 minus e to the power 2 pi over square root of 2. And take out the e to the power 2 pi, and we get a 1 over square root of 2 equals 1 half times the square root of 2 minus I times 1 half times the square root of 2. And you see that it becomes nice, that is just e to the power 2 pi minus I times e to the power minus I times pi over 4, because the number here is modulus 1. That's the right hand side. On to the left hand side. Well, we have z to the power 1 plus I equals e to the power 1 plus I times the log of z, that's a general definition, equals e to the power 1 plus I times the ln of the modulus plus I times the argument. I want to look for principal values of this, which means that the small a is replaced by a capital A, and we get the principal value as e to the power 1 plus I times ln of the modulus of z plus I times the argument of z. End of step B. Now, step C, equate left and right hand side, we get e to the power something equals e to the power something else. So we get e to the power z1 equals e to the power z2. And we have seen that this holds if and only if z1 equals z2 plus a multiple of 2 pi I. So we see that z1, this part, equals z2, this part, plus a multiple of 2 pi I. Now, almost there, we want to solve for z. So we will bring we want to get rid of this 1 plus I, I can do so by dividing by 1 plus I, which equals 1 minus I over 2. And then we are over here. This part equals that part times 1 over 1 plus I equals 1 minus I over 2. And then we have only z's on the left-hand side and only numbers on the right-hand side. So we can solve the real part on the left-hand side has to be equal to the real part on the right-hand side, and the imaginary part on the left-hand side has to be equal to the imaginary part on the right-hand side. So real part left, imaginary part left. Then let's be careful with the real part on the right-hand side. We get 1/2, and then a 1 minus I times this bigger term. A 1 times 2 pi gives something real, 2 pi. And then the 1 times minus I pi over 4, and the 1 times k times 2 pi I doesn't give something real. And then the minus I times minus I pi over 4 also gives something real. It gives a minus pi over 4. And the minus I times k times 2 pi I also gives something real. It gives a k times 2 pi. Now we see on the left-hand side, we have the ln of the modulus. That's something real and has to be positive. So the right-hand side needs to be positive too. Now, if you take, for example, k equals minus 1, you get minus pi over 8 on the right-hand side. That's negative. So you cannot take k equals minus 1 or smaller. However, if you take k 0 or higher, then you're fine. So we see that we have to take k 0, 1, 2, etc. Then onto the second equation. So let's evaluate the imaginary part on the right-hand side. You get a 1 times minus I pi over 4, so minus pi over 4, and a 1 times k times 2 pi I, so 2 pi over here, and then a minus I times 2 pi, so we get a minus 2 pi over there. And notice we have the capital A over here, so this argument has to be between minus pi and pi, so on the right hand side we also need to have something which is between minus pi and pi. So if you take, for example, the k equals 0 on the right hand side, you get minus 2 pi minus pi over 4 divided by 2, so minus pi over 8, which will be outside this range of minus pi pi. So how can we stay within this range? Well, only if we take k equals 1, that's the only option. So if you take k equals 1, those terms drop out, and the argument of z equals minus pi over 8. What do we know about the modulus? Well, the modulus of the ln of z equals 1/2, with the k equals 1, you get 2 pi plus 2 pi equals 4 pi, times this 1/2 if it was 2 pi, minus pi over 8 times 1/2 was minus pi over 8. So the ln of the modulus equals 2 pi minus pi over 8. And we can find our z. Our z finally becomes e to the power 2 pi minus pi over 8 times e to the power I times its argument equals minus pi over 8 e to the power minus I times pi over 8. So you see, yes, we can find those inverse images for a power function, but also see that we need to be really careful when doing this kind of computations.